My second Mach 1 was the 72 that you see here, and trying to stay true to its origins, I didn't put a rear deck spoiler on it. It's a decision that I regret. Fix that today.
The nice thing about this spoiler from National Parts is it comes with some really nice detailed instructions. This should be in your box. If you do not have this, contact National Parts Depot and get a set of instructions, or just watch this video because we're going to go through and basically do everything they do on the instructions, but we're going to show you because we're men and we're visual. So, first thing I want you guys to do is to go out and like and subscribe to the channel. Also, leave a thumbs up, leave a thumbs down. It's entirely up to you. And leave a comment in the section below. Let me know if you think I absolutely suck for having put a rear deck spoiler on my 72 Mach 1. Now, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put in the stanchions. That's these pieces here in the plastic bubble wrap that at some point today one of the kids will probably make off with and make loud popping noises. These go between the stanchion and the deck lid. I'm going to set this aside in the box. I'm going to take and put the stanchion in its position here. Now, on the spoiler, they have a central rest position or a backrest position. This is typically where it's going to sit. I have seen people put these on backwards. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up my bag of goodies here and not cut my hand off maybe. And what you'll want to do is these plates sit on either side here, and these go in first. Now, we also get a hardware kit from the guys at National Parts Depot through AMK. This is as correct as they can make it. Slice that bad boy open, and you'll see that you get pretty much everything you need in order to put this on the car. Okay, so I've got my cloth here that I put underneath the spoiler just as an additional protection. Like I said, I've already cleaned it, so I wasn't that worried about it, but I'm a paranoid, so I put it underneath there. So these screws are a different style of self-tapping screw. You'll see that it's got a larger thread line on it. I'm gonna go ahead and put one in the back on this side so you guys can see it and get it started. Okay, now I'm going to go in and I'm going to take my drill motor and I'm going to take it back so that it doesn't get too overgone because I don't want to strip these threads out. And then I'm going to go in after I get done with all this and finalize this with a screwdriver. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the adjusting Allen screw in here, and the AMK kit comes with a metal washer and a plastic washer per side and an Allen screw. And then you also, with the actual spoiler that comes with it in the box, you have this in this as washers. And what I think I'm going to do here is I'm going to take and put the washer next to the Allen screw here, the metal washer, then the plastic washer on beyond that. And then I'm going to do the same thing going the other way, where I'm going to take this and put the plastic washer facing the stanchion and the metal washer facing the spoiler. Is this correct? I have no idea, but it seems like a good way to do this. So I should be able to move the spoiler around now. I'm going to do the other one off camera because you don't really need to see it. These really won't go in yet, but these are your bolts that go in here. Now, it doesn't come with bolts with the AMK kit, but these are fine. These look exactly like they're supposed to, the right color and everything. And then when you're coming through the bottom of the deck, I'm just going to show you this right now. These will go on here. You've got these rubber caps that go on after you put everything in. So if you're inside the deck lid, like Jackson was the other day when we shut him in the back of there, if the spoiler had been in there, he wouldn't put a hole in his head with this. He would just hurt his head on the rubber cap. This sounds really bad now that I'm saying it out loud. All right, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these out. I'm going to set the deck lid spoiler aside and bring our actual deck lid in here and frighten myself beyond belief whenever we go in and start putting holes in a brand new deck lid. Well, we're about to go in and actually put holes in a brand new deck lid. This is one of the most disconcerting things you can do with this. I am nervous because I am horrible with cutting holes. Cam is out this week. He's not feeling well. So I am going to be the one putting holes in here, and I almost always mess this up. But the instructions are pretty clear. What you're wanting to do is to go over 6 1/4 inches from the edge of the deck lid. So I've got it marked at 6 1/4. And I'm just going to mark my deck lid lightly right now. This is not my final mark. This is just to let me know where to place my tape. I'm using a combination square for this activity because it's just easy to be able to set it up at the 6 1/4 mark, mark right off the end of this. I have a feeling there's a little bit of ish here. At least let's hope so. And I'm going to use some masking tape to mark off where those are so I can make this a lot clearer. Now, if you were working on a final deck lid, I wouldn't recommend doing what I did with the marks at the top. You would want to just make one mark in your position here. And I'm going to just kind of try to center that up on where my mark out was. And now I'm going to go in and mark down here near the base. I'm going to mark a couple of times for my line, because we are going to be going in and also marking for a 10 1/2 inch position as well. So I'm going to take my square and go out to 10 1/2 inches. And I'm assuming when they say that, they mean from the top of the deck lid. Now this is going to be your marked position for the front hole. I'm going to go back to my 6 1/4. On this side, technically, that's where the hole should be. And that corresponds to the divot in the backside of the deck lid right in here. The back of the instructions have a template for where the holes should go for the stanchions for the deck lid spoiler. All right, so what I've done is I've taken my combination square apart. I'm going to lay this on here. I'm going to put it right up against that edge there. I'm going to go make my line. So that right there will give me a line all the way down to where the rear one should sit as well. Now I'm going to go do the other side. I'm going to do that off camera because I've already shown you this one. And then we'll be able to start making holes. All right, last thing I'm going to say about this before we start drilling holes is to measure twice. Cut holes once, and I'm going back through and checking all my measurements with my combination square to make sure they're right where I want them to be. Like now I'm going to go in and set this up for 6 1/4. And I will also then go in and check the measurements on paper. It's easy enough to change the measurements on the tape. Once you cut a hole, you've cut a hole. So we are at 6 1/4. And 6 1/4. Well, it's official. I don't have any more excuses. I've got to go ahead and mark up with my pieces of paper. Here, I'm going to take and cut these out and mark this up. Huzzah. Don't ask me why I do it three times. It's just something I've always done. All right, I think that's it. I'm going to pull this piece of tape and all off in case I need to put it back for any reason. And stick it on the side of my toolbox for the moment. All right, still got my old man readers on, but what I'm doing is I've put a piece of tape on here to keep from going too far into this and marring the finish with the drill here. I don't know that it's really that big a deal because this is going to be covered up by a pad. The holes are going to be probably need to be a little bit bigger than the 5/16. In my experience, that when I do this, the holes are never where they need to be. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and get the first ones drilled because you're going through two layers of metal here. And I don't want the inner hole to be offset. So I'm going to try to keep this on a level plane. Now it's not going to be level for you guys in visual. First layer. And now you know why I put this tape on here. Now this is just my guide holes. I'll go back in now with a larger bit and set those, but I'm gonna go ahead and get this other side done too. I would imagine that when this stuff was done back in the day, that they would have used a fixture for this, that there would have been a piece that they would have sat down on the deck lid to make it happen. So now I'm gonna go in and do my larger drill bit. It's supposed to be a 5/16 hole. Alright, so I'm going to do a test fit. Now the thing I found with these spoilers is it's best to leave the stands loose. When I tried doing it with the stand tightened up completely, it did not like it at all. So it's going to stay loose, and what I'm going to try to do is to go in, tighten the Allens up after I mount it on the car, and I may put an extra washer in there as well, but there you go. I'm going to show you guys how to go in and adjust the tension rods on a 71-3 Mustang in order to get this thing to fit. You may have to increase the hole size just a little bit in order to get the stanchions to go into the holes correctly. We increased ours some just simply because I wasn't real crazy about where I drilled the holes. Like I said, not real good at it. But with the kit that you get from this thing, it's not that big a deal because you got a big washer that goes on the backside of it that'll hide any most amounts of bad drilling. So there you go. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go out and I'm going to fix the tension rods on the deck lid so that we can put this in. Show you how to do that. All right, so adjustment of the deck lid. I'm going to do it with the yellow one. I'm just going to show you what needs to be done. The big problem is that everybody says you need one of these tools, which I made here. It's very nice. It's very neat. And it also doesn't work. I also made this tool before that because I realized that there was going to be a problem. And this one didn't work either. What really works on a 71-3, at least on the sports roof slash fastback, is to use this. Yes, right, a standard vise grip. And what you'll want to do is you'll want to go and grab it right along that shank. Make sure it's really tight. Roll it toward the front of the car. Then you can pull it down and move it where you need it to be. When you're going to be doing this on a car that's getting a rear deck spoiler, you'll want both of these in the holes that are furthest back, closest to the back of the car. So you'll pull it down and rack it into place. And on a 71-3, it's just that easy. Now this tool will work if you're doing anything 1970 on back. This will work on Cougars, whatever. If you're putting a rear deck spoiler on a Cougar, it'll work for that. I have a measured drawing available. It's going to be in the description below. There's a link here, but it's just a write-down link. So if you want to really get to it right away, it's in the description below. And that's that. So that's our show for this week, folks. Thanks for coming into Autorestomod. Be sure to go out and check out our Patreon account at the $5 and $10 a month level. You get meetings with me on Zoom. $5 a month, you get every other month. $10 a month, you get every month with me. And we do tech questions. We have a lot of fun. You need to check it out and go out and look at it. So you guys have a great week, and we'll see you next time on Autorestomod. I wrecked a lot of paint figuring that out. It's okay. I got to back half the car anyway. Now, on to more other things.